Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Ariel, but everyone calls me Ari, and in this channel we talk all things beauty, business, fashion, and positivity. So as you may have noticed, a lot of content creators are hopping on YouTube right now, and starting a YouTube channel has become a trend. And so if you're one of those people who has been thinking of starting a YouTube channel, or you just started one and would like some tips and advice from one small YouTuber to another, then you definitely clicked on the right video. Although my channel is not, you know, big or anything yet, when I did start 2 years ago, I was able to gained 400 subscribers in I think like 2 months, I don't really remember, and ever since I've been back for a month and a half now, I've been able to gain a little bit over 300 subscribers. And so in this video, I'm going to share with you guys some of the things that I think work for me and that I'm sure will work for you as well. So make sure that you stick to the end of this video so that you can hear all the tips and advice that I put together for you guys, so you can finally start your journey as a YouTuber. Before we get started, you already know to hit that subscribe button if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet. Turn on that post notification bell so you never miss when I upload a video, and follow me on Instagram so you can keep up with me. Basically, I divided this video in 3 big parts. So first, we're gonna tackle the behind the scenes section, which is everything that you need to know prior to starting a YouTube channel. And then we're gonna move on to the channel tips, which is basically tips and advice that I put together that small YouTubers like you and myself need to do for the algorithm to work in our favor, for people to subscribe to our channel and stuff. And then finally, we're gonna conclude with things to avoid. Alrighty, so let's start with the behind the scenes section. Number one, you need to truly understand and realize what it actually means to be a YouTuber. As you may have noticed, a lot of people are starting a YouTube channel right now, and as you may have also noticed, a lot of people quickly give up. And the reason that is because they don't realize from the get-go what it actually means to be a YouTuber and a content creator on YouTube. First of all, being a content creator on YouTube is very, very time consuming. When you see people like myself post a video once a week, that may look easy to accomplish, but that one video might actually have taken someone like a week to prepare. From preparing the video to recording it and then to editing it, it takes a lot of time for you to just get one video. Now, of course, some people might say that it really doesn't take them that long for them to like record and edit a video, but I'm obviously speaking from a perspective of someone who's taking YouTube really, really serious, and I firmly believe that if you want to have valuable quality content, that will definitely take time. So are you willing to sacrifice a good amount of your time to video production and content creating on YouTube? That is definitely something you need to keep in mind and you need to consider prior to starting a YouTube channel. If you're a college student like myself, or you have other duties that would be outside of YouTube, then it's definitely something to consider, like I said, and it is very much possible, but you just need to be as disciplined and as organized as possible to make that happen. So just keep that in mind. And something else that you also need to realize is that at first you're going to be spending some money, and I personally think of them as like investments, as they are going to help your channel tremendously, but it's still something to keep in mind. And this actually brings up the next point of the behind the scenes section, which is equipment. This is what you're gonna be spending your money on at first for your channel to look professional from the jump. Number one, camera. This is actually the first video that's coming out with my brand new camera that I got myself as an early birthday gift. But before I had this camera, I used to record with my iPhone 10. So all the videos before this one were recorded with my iPhone 10. And as you can see, the quality is really, really not that bad. Yeah, you definitely don't need a camera to start whatsoever. Like if you have an iPhone, you're more than good. iPhone quality is amazing. So definitely start with your phone at first. But what's going to enhance the quality of your videos is lighting and sound. Alrighty, so as far as lighting, I use this ring light that I got from Amazon, and I'm gonna be attaching the direct link to the exact ring light in the description box, so make sure you check that out after the video. And let's say that you wanna start, but you can't afford a ring light right now, then just make sure that wherever you record, that you get really, really good lighting from the sun, because lighting is really, really important for your videos. Sound is also really, really good for your videos, and I actually just got a new mic, but the mic that I've been using in most of my videos before the one that I just got is like this $15 one from Amazon. I'm not really sure what the price was, but you can definitely find it on Amazon. I'm going to be attaching the direct link to that one as well in the description box. But yeah, I really like this mic. It's super cheap, so it's perfect to start with. Last but not least, at least for now, is storage. Storage is really, really important, y'all. As you're going to keep making videos and editing videos, you're going to quickly run out of space, and you don't want your device to start tripping on you, like your laptop and stuff. So definitely investing in an external hard drive is beneficial and is essential for your channel. I also got this one from Amazon, and I believe that that one was like $60, and that might sound like a lot, but trust me guys, you're gonna need this. Like, I swear you're gonna need it at some point or another, so might as well get it from the beginning. Alrighty guys, so now that you have an idea of how time consuming being a YouTuber is, how much equipment is gonna cost you at first, let's now move on to the last point of the behind the scenes section, which is the theme or themes of your channel. So what is your channel gonna talk about? That is really, really important for you to know exactly what you're going to be talking about on your channel. The more specific you are about the theme or themes of your channel, the better it is for you and your future audience. For example, my channel is all about beauty, business, fashion, and positivity, like I said in the beginning, so that's just one example. One thing that a lot of successful YouTubers talk about, and from the research that I've done, they always stress how much you don't want your channel to be too diverse. For example, like one cooking video one day and then like a makeup tutorial the next, because people who will eventually subscribe to your channel will subscribe to your channel because of particular videos that they enjoy from you, meaning that they expect to see it frequently and consistently. So yeah, try to be as specific as possible about the theme or themes of your channel so that your audience knows exactly what they can expect from you, which will make them want to stick around. So keep this in mind. Topic coverage is what your videos will talk about. Target audience is who your videos are intended for. And reason for existence is why people should watch your videos. This will help you have a clear and concise idea of what your channel will talk about, which is going to help you tremendously when preparing for it. Alrighty, so now that we've tackled what goes on behind the scenes of starting a YouTube channel, let's now move on to the second section of this video, which is channel tips. There are three main things I feel like will help you and I both as small YouTubers tremendously. Number one, presentation. Number two, promotion. Number three, consistency. As small YouTubers, presentation is so important, and I feel like that's like the number one thing that will help you tremendously when starting. First impressions really, really matter, especially because we're small YouTubers. Standing out is a must. First of all, the first thing that people see when they click on your channel is your banner and the thumbnail of your videos. So what that lets you know is that those two things need to look bomb and on point. Because before anyone even cares to check out your videos, that's the first thing they're gonna see. So if anything, you wanna make sure that your banner and the thumbnail of your videos invite people to check you out. If you don't know how to make YouTube banners yourself, a lot of people hire someone to get it done professionally, which is something I would recommend you guys to do. And as far as thumbnails, I think you can get that done professionally as well. But honestly, I would recommend you guys to save your money, because you have amazing platforms like Canva where they have a bunch of thumbnail templates for you guys to customize and, like, you know, change around the colors and the title and stuff to fit your channel. And the thing about Canva is that they're so professional, everything looks so nice, and it's free, so you guys have no excuses as to why your thumbnails are not looking bomb. So yeah, like, now that your banner and your thumbnails look bomb, people will most likely click on your videos, and you want to make sure that now your actual video is also bomb. And that all comes down to the place that you record your videos. As you can see, I have my little setup here, the editing of the video, of course, lighting and sound, which is why I told you guys to invest in a microphone and a ring light, and just the overall quality of the video. You want to make sure that the video is really, really good. As far as editing, I use Final Cut Pro X, and that's what most YouTubers, all your favorite YouTubers including me, use to edit their videos. And guys, iMovie is cute or whatever, but like, Final Cut Pro X is where it's at. Guys, I know how expensive Final Cut Pro X is, but it all comes down to how serious you are about YouTube. And if you are, I would tell you 100% that it's worth it. But yeah, basically what I'm trying to stress with this presentation section is how important your presentation is as a small YouTuber. That's gonna make people wanna check out your channel, to then watch your videos, to then subscribe and show you support. Remember that no one owes you anything, and like, no one owes you to click on your channel and like spend 15 minutes of their day watching your content. So you want to make sure that you win them over, if anything, through a nicely organized and professional looking channel. Number two, promotion. So because we're small YouTubers and we don't have a lot of traffic yet on YouTube, we're gonna rely heavily on other social media platforms for people to go check out our channel. I'm assuming that most of you who are watching this video already have a following on other social media platforms. So what you're gonna do is use apps like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, whatever you have, to heavily promote your video. You can always do some self-promotion as well by DMing people directly, texting your family and friends, and like, tell them, hey, I just, you know, launched a YouTube channel, I would love for you to subscribe, I just launched this video, I would love for you to check it out and leave me a little like, comment, subscribe to my channel, blah 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 blah. But yeah, promotion is obviously gonna help a lot at first with our channel, because that's where our first subscribers are gonna come from. And Instagram even has a paid promotion for you to promote your post. So let's say you post about like a video that you just posted on YouTube, you can always promote that on Instagram so that people can, like, you know, check out your profile and then check out the link in your bio and hopefully subscribe to your channel. So yeah, guys, post your channel on every single platform that you possibly could and get the word out about your channel, because that's going to help you tremendously at first, like I said. Last but not least, consistency. This one is really, really tough, guys, but there's nothing better for the success of your channel and the growth of your channel than consistency. Every book that I've read, any research that I made, all of them stress how important consistency is for the success of your YouTube channel. Number one, the more you record videos, the better you get at filming, the more comfortable you are behind the camera. Similarly, the more you edit videos, the better you get at editing. So that's one way that you can see how consistency is really, really good. Number two, the more consistent you are, the more you build a connection with your audience, which is essential for the growth of your channel. Number three, the more you upload, like the more frequently and consistently that you upload, the more the YouTube algorithm will work in your favor. So for example, right, let's say you have like 7 videos and then you upload an 8th video, and that 8th video does really, really good, right? Because that 8th video does really, really good, all these people who checked out that 8th one are obviously gonna check out all these 7 other ones. So, like, that's why being consistent is really, really good, because by being so consistent, what you're doing is increasing the probability for your videos, for your channel to be successful. So the more videos you have, the better. And I know as a small YouTuber how annoying it can get, how discouraging it can be when like you work so hard on a video and it's not really doing the numbers that you expected it to or whatever, but that's why it's important for you not to pay too much attention to the numbers, because you will quickly get like disappointed. You want to make sure that if anything, you just stick to the consistency, because that's really what's going to help you, because you never know what video is just going to blow up or like do really good that's going to help all the other videos on your channel. Like, you don't even need to look at it that way, like as in like blowing up or whatever, because every single time I upload a video, my views for my other videos always go up. Even if it's like a little bit, it always goes up. And the reason that is because the people that are watching my recent upload will most likely go check out some other videos on my channel. So you see how like consistency is just like amazing for your channel. So try to think of a day or two or three of when you will be uploading a video on YouTube. Let your audience know, and that not only builds like, you know, a connection with your audience because they know exactly when they can expect, you know, some content from you, but that also keeps you accountable. So yeah, so that's it for this section. Obviously there's way more that goes into it, but this is like an introductory video, so that's why everything is like an overview of everything. So yeah, anyway, let's move on to the last section of today's video, which is things to avoid when starting a YouTube channel. There's only mostly 2 things. So number one, try not to do it too much for the money. Obviously we all know that we can start making money off of YouTube. We've seen people become millionaires off being a YouTuber, but you need to not try to think too much of the money aspect of YouTube. And the reason that is because we're small YouTubers, so for us to even get to the point where we can start making money is kind of like a long road. So if you're focused too much on the money, you're gonna quickly get discouraged, because like I said in another video, when you're less focused on the end goal, I feel like the results come faster, if you see what I mean. So yeah, guys, just keep having fun with like recording, with editing, with cool ideas for you to bring to the table, because that's truly what's going to matter at the end of the day. Number two, avoid doing sub for subs. When I first started, I'm not gonna lie, I used to do some sub for subs, and I get why people do it, but when I started doing some research on like YouTube and stuff and started reading books, that is not recommended at all. And the reason why actually makes perfect sense. First of all, the people that you do sub for subs with most likely have nothing to do with your channel, and so they're like not valuable audience whatsoever. So yeah, guys, you're better off with 50 real subscribers that actually watch your content, who like your videos, who comment on your stuff and actually engage with your videos, which is what you need, which is what is more important, instead of having 100 subscribers that like don't watch your videos, don't engage with your content, and who are basically some dead subscribers. And that all goes back to the point I was making earlier about not caring too much about the numbers. So yeah, definitely try to stay away from sub for subs. Alrighty guys, so that's it for today's video. If you're a small YouTuber like myself, then I hope that you learned a thing or two today and that this video helped you somehow. If you did, make sure to give me a little like, leave me a comment. If you have any questions or concerns, leave me a comment or DM me on my Instagram. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.